Hello boys and girls, my name is Teacher Khomotso and today we are here to learn about the Word of God. I hope we're all excited because I know I am. Okay, so boys and girls, without wasting any time, can we please close our eyes, let us settle down and let us open up in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We thank you for your mercies and your grace. We thank you, oh Heavenly Father, for protecting us throughout this week. We thank you, oh God, for keeping us healthy in Jesus' mighty name. Heavenly Father, I pray that whatever we're going to learn today, we are going to take to our friends, our families, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Alrighty, boys and girls, now it is time for praise and worship. So let us stand up and get ready to dance for the Lord.
Well, howdy! I sure am glad to bump into y'all. I thought I was lost down here all by myself. These old mine train tracks run all through here like spaghetti. Ain't no way to be remembering where all the tracks go. That's why we done made ourselves a system using none other than the books of the good book. I'm talking about the Bible. Now, my memory ain't what it used to be, so I'ma need your help to get us out of here. Every time these old tracks cross, we stuck ourselves a sign with the name of two books of the Bible on it. One will be from the Old Testament, and the other will be from the New Testament. To help us get out of this old mine, make sure to lean toward the sign with the Old Testament book. But if y'all lean toward the sign with the New Testament book, this old train car will just end up even deeper in this mine. Jeepers, no! I'll be keeping a handle on these old rusty brakes so we don't go flying off the tracks. Alrighty, let's go to it then. Here's our first sign. Which of these books is in the Old Testament? Exodus or Luke? Remember, raise your hands and lean towards the sign with the Old Testament book so we can get this old mine car headed in the right direction. Well, paint me yellow and call me a gold nugget. We might be getting out of this mine today. You're right. Exodus is in the Old Testament. Good work. Oh, I think we've got another sign coming up. Which of these books is in the Old Testament? Revelation or Genesis? Well, dip me in ketchup and call me a corn dog. You're right. Genesis is in the Old Testament. Well done. Now, hang on tight. Here comes the next sign. Which of these books is in the Old Testament? Philippians or Proverbs? Well, cover me in butter and call me a biscuit. You're right. Proverbs is in the Old Testament. Good job. Ooh, I think I see our next sign up ahead. Which of these books is in the Old Testament? Deuteronomy or Colossians? Well, stick me in the dirt and call me a tater. You're right. Deuteronomy is in the Old Testament. Way to go. Ooh, I think we're getting close to getting out of here. Here comes the next sign. Which of these books is in the Old Testament? Daniel or Matthew? Well, smother me in syrup and call me a waffle. You're right. Daniel is in the Old Testament. Oh, I think we've just got this one last turn to make, and we'll be out of here. Which of these books is in the Old Testament? Esther or Romans? Well, put me in a pot and call me a stew. You're right. Esther is in the Old Testament. Woo-hoo! I'm happier than a flea in a pet store. You guys did it. You remembered your books of the Bible and got us out of that old mine. Much obliged for your assistance. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna get some lunch at the Gold Spur. I hear they make a mean corn dog biscuit, potato, and waffle stew. My favorite. Yeehaw!
Okay, boys and girls, now it is time to listen to the word of God. I know we're all excited, but can we kindly just sit down and listen to the word of God?
Good morning, boys and girls. Good morning. What a great pleasure to have you joining us again this morning. This is Agape Family Church, where God is at the head and love is at the center of all that we do. We are a church that seeks to demonstrate God's unconditional love to all mankind and to develop Christian leaders who will impact the marketplace for Christ. Welcome to our Sunday worship experience, and we such a great pleasure to have you joining us again this morning. When we say this is the day that the Lord has made, we will be glad and rejoice in it. Indeed, we rejoice in his presence. We give him all the glory. We thank him for who he is in our lives, and we appreciate him. Let us bow and pray. Heavenly Father, Lord Almighty, thank you for blessing us with yet another day. Thank you for your grace, O Lord, that is so sufficient for all of us. We honor you this morning, Lord. We magnify your holy name. We give you all the glory, Lord. Lord, as we are about to hear your word, we pray that you prepare our thoughts. You help us to be able to hear what is going to be shared here with us. Spirit of the living God, we honor you this morning. Use us, therefore, Lord, as your vessels. Help us, Lord, in all that we need as your children, Lord, are gathered here this morning. We give you glory. We magnify your holy name, Spirit of the living God. Take charge, Lord. Amen. Amen, boys and girls. Amen, boys and girls. Such a great pleasure to have you joining us again. Today we're celebrating you as the children. We're celebrating you because we've just celebrated the International Children's Day, and we give you all the glory. We honor you. We thank God. We thank God for your lives. We thank God for all that he has done for you and protected you and keep you safe throughout. So we're going to get straight to the word of God. We are going to read from the book of Colossians 3, verse 20 and 21. If you're ready, get your Bibles and then we'll get to read together. So I'm going to read from the International Children's Bible, ICB. When you're ready, Colossians 3, verse 20 and 21. Verse 20. Children, obey your parents in all things. This pleases the Lord. 21. Fathers, do not nag your children. If you are too hard to please, they may want to stop trying. Amen. So 20 says, children, obey your parents in all things. This pleases the Lord. This command has a very powerful instruction on it. That whatever you do, obeying your parents, it not only pleases your parents, but above everything else, it pleases the Lord. So you're doing it for the Lord. You're not doing it for your parents. You're not doing it for your parents. So the command is based on what you do and how you do it. Then that pleases the Lord. So you can do anything that your parents want you to do. Your parents will guide you, will teach you all their responsibilities. They will instill values in you. They will teach you about Christ, the reality about sin, the reality about forgiveness, and the need, why we need to forgive, and all of those things. But if you keep on doing those things that your parents ask you to do, you are not just doing it for your parents. It pleases the Lord. So every time you need to do something, remember that, yes, I need to respect my parents. Yes, I need to do what my parents says I need to do. But above everything else that I'm doing, God is also watching. God also gets pleased. God also, he becomes happy with what I'm doing as a child. And that also, it also pleases me as an individual that I am doing what needs to be done, and I am doing it for the Lord. So it's very important that by showing honor and respect to our parents, this on its own, it pleases God. So it's very important that we do that. And then 21 says, fathers, do not nag your children. If you are too hard to please, they may want to stop trying, or they may be discouraged. So we need to be very careful of what we do and how we do it. But it's not only talking to fathers. So at this, I will refer to all the parents, even mom, your mommies as well. So fathers and mothers, if you nag too much, if you are too hard to please, this will be difficult for your children. They'll stop trying. So we need to appreciate what the children are doing. It's very important to think of what we say, how we talk to our children, how we bring authority over them, and be mindful of the impact of our words towards the children. Because now with all of that, you will stop even realizing that their children are trying, that they're doing their best because they're not pleasing you. So you end up having to be hard on them. And when you hard on them, they will resent what you want them to do. But it's very important that you guide and protect and love them and honor them and show them what they need to do. So how we communicate with them, it can either crush them or frustrate them, or it can encourage them and build them. But the aim here is to make sure that we encourage them, we build them, so we give them love, we give them hope, because that's what they see and that's what they know from us. So let us be their safe space. Let us be able to guide them. So when they're doing wrong, guide them. Do not crush them. Do not frustrate them, because that would also be difficult for them. So they will stop trying. And when they start stop trying, you also be worried that why they're not doing what they are doing, what they're supposed to be doing. But above everything else, we've learned that when they obey you, they please God. So it's very important that we work with them throughout, so that they also build confidence within themselves and say, my parents trust me, my parents appreciate who I am and appreciate what I'm doing, then they will keep on doing that, and that will then build confidence within them. They are looking for love, they are looking for guidance, they are looking for the support from us. So when we're struggling to give them that, then they also struggle to give it back. So it's very important that as parents, so this message is more for parents to say, ask God for guidance, ask God to help you in your role that you play as a parent, how to raise them in the Lord, teach them to follow the God's way, teach them to follow God's instructions, God's commands, set the examples, walk the talk, walk the talk. These children, they are the gifts from God. They are the gift from God. So what do you do when you receive a gift? You appreciate the gift. You love the gift. So you do that. Cherish them. Embrace them. Love them. Support them. Be there for them. Protect them in all things that they do, in all places where they are. Show them love. Honor them. Because if you do that, then they will obey you. They will obey you. And in them obeying you, God get pleased. It pleases the Lord. That's what the command says. So today, children, enjoy your day. Celebrate being children. Celebrate who you are. Embrace your creativity. Embrace who you are. And parents, let's love them. Let's honor them. Let's show them the love. Let's walk the talk. Let's teach them about Christ. Let's teach them about God's commandments and teach them of all the things that they need to know. Above everything else, let's help them to build confidence in who they are, and they will be able to appreciate themselves going forward. This is the message that I wanted to share with you today. Have a great day. Let us pray together. Spirit of the living God, we thank you for these children. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your support. We thank you, Lord. We pray that you be with them in everything that they do. Guide and protect them, guide and show them the way, Spirit of the living God. We pray that whatever that they do at school, Lord, they become successful, they achieve their goals, they achieve what they've said they want to achieve, and all that they do, they put you first, Lord. Because in everything that happens around us, your purpose is the one that prevails at all times. Spirit of the living God, we honor you this morning. And we give you glory, now and forever, Lord. Amen.
Okay, boys and girls, now it is time to say our goodbyes. I hope you all had a really good time. I hope you all learned something today. Let us all go share something that we learned from our teachers, you know, and just go spread the love of God. And without wasting any time, let us close our eyes in prayer. Thank you, O Heavenly Father, for bringing us together today. I thank you, oh God, that you were able to speak through our teachers and that you are able to use them to teach us so many things about you. Oh Heavenly Father, may we grow to love you as much as our teachers love you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Bye, boys and girls.